What's going on, guys? Johnny with Blades of Grass Lawn Care. This morning, I'm at my 4-in-a-row property. Okay, good. I'm connected to my music. IsoTunes, guys. If you don't know about IsoTunes, look in the video description and you will see a link and a bio. So this morning is a little bit chilly. I was just looking at Brian's lawn maintenance story, and man, it was like 49. That's crazy. Then I get up today and it's freaking 61. So that's amazing. It's 60 doggone one. But hey, it is what it is, right? All right. I know I have a mess. I gotta try to get these done. Good morning. And first thing is first. As of right now, I have this one and the one over there. But yeah, we're gonna get them done. And let me get my battery. It's a little chilly this morning, huh?
It feels so good though.
It does. All right, so take my cover off, unlock this, and I can't believe it. Somebody's out here actually mowing before I started mowing. Now the goal, not the goal, guys, but it's gonna trip you guys out. Hopefully, anyway, once I start mowing, because you know that mower is not making a lot of noise. So once I get out here and start making that noise, boy, oh my goodness, they're gonna start popping out. But it's all good. That's what it's all about, right? All right, put this here for now. Put my battery in. Oh, dag. I guess I'll grab an old battery. Let me grab something a little bit more. There you go. And there you go. All right, let's edge. Sometimes I edge first and sometimes I edge after, but I'll edge first today. When it comes to edging, guys, it depends on how I feel. Sometimes I edge after, sometimes I edge before. It really doesn't matter to me, unless it's something overgrown. I do apologize for the wind, guys. By the time it hit us, it's gonna be a thunderstorm. Ian, I think it is. As of right now, anyway. So remember the issue I had with this property where this guy was supposed to call me? He called, but I'm still working on it, but I can still use his, use it back to get to the back of this property. There you go. See how quick that was? Quick and quiet. Man, I need Toros to give me that $34,000 lawnmower, the quiet one. Anyway, put this in here and get this mower. So at this time of the year, guys, I bring my all my properties down to 2 inches, and I keep them at 2 inches for the winter. And right now, all these properties is getting cool, so the grass is gonna start slowing down big time. What did I do with the key? Oh. It's in my... Hey guys, do you guys keep the keys to your lawnmower? When you park your lawnmower in your trailers, right? Or wherever. Do you leave the keys in there? I don't. Yes, you know, you can say that all keys...
if I can find my damn key.
All keys will fit a specific lock, but the reality is that it gives whoever a little bit more of a hard time to get into your stuff or take your stuff if they don't physically have the key ready available. I know I have my key around here somewhere. Additional string, of course. I gotta put this in here. Maybe I need to take this off first. See guys, ain't no preparation here. This is a real deal. This is the way it happens. You know, a lot of time you see YouTube videos and everything is perfect, right? Nope, that's not the way it is. I will show you that I tend to mess up. I mean, the other key will fit, but boy, I can't believe. I'll have to use a big key. I try to find the actual key for it, but I All right. Now it's time for my music. Let's put on some Sirius XM. Free commercial for them, right? Thank you. now we trim. There you go. Not bad, right? All right, then we go to the next one.
Thank you.
Now this is a water meter. You see where they put it? It's crazy, right? Yep, that's it. Let me go this way. It stays super wet. And that's it, guys. I had this blower for about 6 years now. Oh. ER600. Let me go blow over here first, and then work my way back here. So, let's go back. Blowing all over. Against the wind.
Thank you.
All right. There it is. Two properties done. So I know you guys are wondering, how much do I charge for these properties? And I charge $55 per service visit. So anytime I come out here, it's $55 per property. So that's $110, right? Yep. But Johnny, I could never get that where I'm at. Yes, you can. You just have to find the right location. That's all it is. All right, one thing that I want to tell you guys, man, and this is honestly, let me turn my headgear back. Guys, let me tell you, a lot of times it kind of disappoints me when I hear guys say, well, I can't make that kind of money in my area. Come on, guys. No such animal. No such thing. Because if you think about it, it depends on where you are marketing. Simple as that. It depends on where you are targeting your customers. Now, if you're driving around just trying to pick up this person and that person, they only need a cut here, they only need a cut there, you know, then you're going to get, you know, you can't expect the same results. You have to target neighborhoods that value what you do. You have to target customers that want a pretty lawn, customers that want a schedule, customers that are busy professionals that don't have time to maintain their property, so therefore they need somebody to take care of it for them. We are problem solvers. That's all we do. Okay? They come home, they see their yard, it's a problem. Who they're gonna call? Us, the problem solvers. You know? So again, guys, it's where you're targeting as far as location, where you're marketing. Go to those HOA neighborhoods, go to those subdivisions, and I know a lot of you guys live different places or whatever the case might be, find them. That's what I do. I could easily target, you know, people around my house or whatever, but the joke is there's no HOA. There's no HOA, so therefore they want to call you when the grass is, you know, by your nose, and then once you tell them the price, they look at you like you're crazy. Well, such and such charges, well, go call such and such because I'm not such and such. You see what I mean? Guys, think about it. Again, is where you target your business is not your location. I promise you. Because back in the days, there used to be other YouTubers around my area that used to say the same thing. I could never get this. This is the most I could get. And I was making 20, 30% more than what they were making. Why? Because who I target and what I do. Of course, you have to be good at what you do. But guys, target the right location. Have a blessed one, guys. Hope you learned something from this video. Hope you enjoy this video. Leave your comment in the comment section below. Share, subscribe, follow, go to my Instagram, all that good stuff, guys. Have a blessed one. Pop Smoke. Peace.